Well, when I was a kid, I was a huge Dick Tracy fan. And so I guess I kind of came to learn about the genre through that film. And I also was like kind of had an affection for that time period as well, you know. Well, I think that it's true, you know. I mean, I guess it's a very fictionalized version of the truth, but rooted in somewhat in reality, you know, that there was this group of men who did this very incredible thing. You know, they put their lives on the line in order to fight for the freedom of this city and for their families. And you know, in some ways, even though this is a sensationalized version of that, the truth is like somehow more unbelievable. Well, I never got a chance to work with Sean, but I watched him from the sidelines, and you know, I think he just jumped in with both feet. You know, he had no real, he really gave it everything he had, which I thought was really cool. You know, I thought he could have come in and played it a bit safer, but he put it all on the line. And I think, you know, Josh is, in a lot of ways, he's kind of like this character, you know? And I think the movie works because he's believable in the sense that you think Josh Brolin could put together a group like this to follow him into a fight, you know? And in terms of Ruben, I just think really interesting approach, because he was a history major in school and he had a very academic approach to the historical aspects of the film, and yet he was taking such liberties with them, and then also doing like a stylized version of it. So it's a really interesting, those two qualities in him, I think, make for an interesting stamp on the genre.